Thomas
Comedies.
Greetings, this is your sexy voice-like narrator here to tell you a tale about fear, hope, and one of the best crashes you might ever see. Gordon is a big blue express engine. He is proud of being the express engine, and loves to be the most important engine than any other. But one day, Gordon was feeling crosser than usual. This was making James grumpy.
Okay, Gordy, why are you complaining all the time? It's getting really annoying, especially since you just decided to make the indignity an internet meme.
Because it will be a meme. It will be turned into a t-shirt, even if you have to say it every time. Also because I'm a big blue engine and I can complain whenever I want. You're just a medium-sized red engine with no ideas above your station.
Ideas of what, Gordy?
What the crap happened to your voice?
Oh yeah, well it all started about 3 weeks ago after I had 32 bottles of lemons. Anyway, I can't see a station in the sky. The sky's clear.
Like a smoke box.
Listen up, you two. One day, I will show you idiots what a big engine can really do.
So what can a big engine do?
Not speak to little green puffballs who have an IQ of 45.
It's an IQ of 46, you f***ing moron. And is it true that big engines can make gummy bears fall from the sky?
Goodbye, Percy. Jamie.
Did he just call me Jamie?
Yes, so what? You're not a girl.
Let me just say I was being voiced by one. You sound like a little schoolgirl anyhow.
I do? I've been lied to. I must consult an adult. Also, check out Dangerous 3, The Criminal Projective. Now available on DVD and Blu-ray.
And also,
please subscribe to the following people that you see on the screen. It's free and easy. If you subscribe to one of these people in less than 10 minutes, we'll give you a pair of sweatpants. It's really all we can do for you, really.
When Gordon was resting in the siding, the Fat Controller arrived.
Gordon, you must take an empty express to test out the new station at Kirk Ronan.
I don't want to go. There's that old engine who keeps saying the strangest things to any engine who dare passes.
You must do as you're told, or do I have to give your computer the blue screen of death?
I don't have a computer!
Oh, then whose computer did I touch then? Who cares? Just go to Kirk Ronan and then you can run away before Neil scares you to death. Just look what happened to Thumper.
Get away from me!
It's okay, Thumper. It's only me.
You dare take one more step closer? I'm warning you! Don't make me use it!
This would never have happened if you just said no to cake.
Do not disrespect the cake. It feeds us all.
Soon, Gordon made it to the new station. He was impressed, but his mood soon changed.
What a boring view. Important engines like me deserve a panoramic view, where I can see people, and people can see me.
Yes.
Oh, goody. Hello, Neil.
Hello there, Gordy. What brings you here?
Well, just to test this station and, well, I hate this wall in front of me. I deserve a panoramic view here.
Yes. But for you hating the wall hates you back.
What do you mean?
This wall is haunted. It contains an evil devil inside of it. A devil whose name we do not speak.
Is it like Lord Voldemort's name, where if you say it, he'll come and get you?
No, I just don't remember the name. Now, where was I? Oh yeah. The wall itself is a demon, and will haunt you and your friends' damn nightmares. It hungers for blood, and its next victim
is you.
Actually, now that you say it, this wall is creeping me out some. I'm going back home.
I just love screwing around with people.
Stupid Neil. Of course walls aren't scary. They're just stupid.
You will perish in the fire, somehow, where the demons Asmodeus and Asmoroth feast on your flesh and chew your eyeballs. Then a thousand years of blazing torment.
Sweet Christmas! Did I just saw the wolf talking to me? Maybe. Maybe Neil's right.
That's right.
Just then, James puffed up.
What up, Gordy? The James Denator's in the house.
James, I have seen the ending. No one came back alive. Not even the children.
Let me guess. Neil?
He's bloody right, you know. The Kirk Ronan station walls are evil.
You are afraid of the new station walls?
Yes.
Okay, have I seen worse excuses for a plot device than this? But a phobia of walls? Oh, come on.
What do I do to get rid of this fear?
Well, let's see. If Neil caused it, and he made up this plot device,
Well?
To Dr. Henry Ellenington!
Are you sure he can fix me?
Of course, you idiot! Besides, he only get rid of my fear of bees! Excuse me, Mr. Voodoo Priest?
Why, hello there, customer number 13. What brings you into my lair?
I got another one. Nice to see by the old man of Kirk Ronan.
I see. Well, this is no surprise, since I already fixed the 24 other engines who had the same disease. This also includes that orange fellow who gave me this mark on my tender. Yes. But I am willing to do what my teddy bear tells me to, and help those who have been affected by the old man of Kirk Ronan. And then after testing, the patient will be bait, and then there will be cake. So, who is the next savior?
That will be me!
Oh! Hello, Gordon! What do you want?
James told me that you specialize in curing for the sick, right?
Yes, by the power of the World Wide Web that gave me this diploma.
Okay, good. Cause Neil gave me a phobia of walls. Also, he keeps saying that I have 7 days to live.
Is he serious?
Hey, I was just as confused as you are.
Okay, come with me, Gordumb. I shall help you get rid of your fear of walls.
Later that night, Henry got everything set up to help Gordumb out, although Gordumb was a bit worried.
This is stupid. Ouch!
Do you want to get rid of your phobia or what?
Yes, sir.
Good! Now, underneath this cover here, there is a wall. When I reveal it to you, you will punch the wall as hard as you can.
Okay.
Let me say it again. When I reveal it to you, there is no... Repeat, no! Turning back. Do you understand?
Well...
I saw no turning back!
I didn't even say!
Aye, listen to the voodoo priest.
How long have you been standing there?
Oh, let's just hear just in case you failed the mission.
What happens if I fail?
We get to throw you in the fire!
Great, just perfect.
Okie dokie! 1, 2, flee!
It's too scary!
My goddess! It's worse than I thought, laddies! Confess! Confess your sins by punching the demon!
I can't!
Do it now!
Or forever burn in Vickerstown!
I can't! I just can't!
Confess! 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 Confess!
Ah!
Mm-hmm.
you just punched the damn wall already?
I am a man!
He's saved!
Ugh, yay! I got that bonfire ready for nothing.
Tell me, Gordumb, how do you feel?
I feel pretty good.
Good! Now listen very, 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 very closely if you want to get rid of your phobia completely.
I'm listening.
Tomorrow, when you go to cook grilling, ram into that wall like it was Sunday Night Football!
Wait, what?
You heard me, boy.
Would it be considered as property damage or something?
Do you want the phobia gone or what?
I guess.
Then destroy the flippin' thing. It offends the Scottish in many ways.
Later the next morning, Gordumb woke up, ready to test the station one last time. But unknown to his driver, he was going to ram into the wall.
Well, I'm off to the station. Wish me luck, everyone.
Watch out for the wall!
Yeah, the rhino will eat you!
Hey, what did I say about using violence, schoolgirl?
Oh, the indignity!
Make us proud, Gordumb! What?
Remember the mission! Remember the mission! Remember the mission!
Hey, Joel. Would it suck if some engine crashed into that wall over there?
Yeah. It would also suck if we had to rebuild that whole wall in one day.
That would be stupid.
I will destroy you, evil wall.
Well, I can safely say that this is the first time someone took me seriously.
Oh, my head. I've done it. I did it! I destroyed the wall!
Yes, you have, Gordon. Yes, you have. Also, you managed to break my arm and leg, killed your fireman, and caused a hole into my new station! Do you know how much this will cost us?
You can get a new one! As long as my phobia of walls is gone, then I am A-okay.
Oh, this is the exact reason why I prefer smaller engines.
Good evening, morning, noon, whatever. Yesterday, the newly built Kurt Ronan station had an unlucky grand opening as locomotive number 4 crashed into the wall. The engine stated that he did it only to get rid of his phobia of walls. We went to interview a few engines to see if they knew what was going on in the loco's mind.
Mr. Henry, did you know anything about locomotive number 4's phobia of walls?
Nope. Never saw the poor sausage in my life.
The loco stated that you told him to ram into the station walls. Is that true?
What? I will never tell someone to do such a thing. It's probably because it's the son and never really loved him. Or maybe it's because he never got that extra tender like his brother did. I don't know.
Mr. Percy, do you know anything about locomotive number 4?
Well, he said that I was a schoolgirl from Japan, which makes no sense considering that I'm part Australian. Also, he keeps stealing my Xbox 360 and he throws tomatoes at me!
Percy, that's all by me!
Oh, in that case, I have no idea what you're talking about.
The station master says that there will be a panoramic view for him, just to keep his phobia to a cool. The station will be back up sometimes today, with the workmen going on a rampage for a bigger paycheck. Coming up on Sodor today, news about the Mullins crew making a Thomas and the Magic Railroad redub for their 10th redub, Angry Birds for the Wii, and when the hell is Shenmue 3 coming out? We now return to your regular soap opera.